What if everyone could have access to a healthy, comfortable, energy efficient home that's built without damaging the planet with very little waste? What if that was possible? There's more people every day on the planet. We just don't have a way currently to provide a healthy, comfortable, and sustainable homes to these people. So what if we could do that by leveraging technology? I came to Stanford to do my master's in civil engineering, and I really came here because I wanted to explore even further outside of just a specific topic. And that's something that Stanford I knew could bring. I ended up taking machine learning classes in the School of Business, some real estate classes, and that was the most interesting part. I ended up heading the expansion of Bone Structure in the US. Bone Structure is our family business that we started back in Montreal in Canada. We are building high performance custom homes, so very energy efficient homes built with practically zero waste. No one in my family is an engineer, and we started Bone Structure out of a personal experience when my parents decided to build their dream home, their personal custom home. It was not such a great experience, way over time, over budget, the classic story that you hear. And my father, being from the aerospace industry, not as an engineer, but just surrounded by engineers, really saw the contrast between what he saw in the aerospace industry and what we were experiencing on a personal level building our own home. That triggered my parents to start Bone Structure. Our first project, when we launched our office, Bone Structure office in California, we landed right back on campus. Ironically, our first client was a professor here at Stanford in the Atmosphere and Energy program.
We've been developing plans to change the energy infrastructure of states and countries to 100% clean renewable energy. That's to eliminate all air pollution worldwide. In order to solve the warming problem, to prevent temperatures which have already increased 1 degree Celsius since the early 1900s, to prevent 1.5 degrees Celsius warming, which will cause lots of catastrophic problems worldwide. The only way to do this is eliminate 80% of emissions by 2030 and 100% by 2050. And the only way to eliminate 80% of emissions by 2030 is to start aggressively today by stopping the use of fossil fuels and biofuels that contribute to climate gases and particles as well. My work and my personal life are intertwined in that I try to practice what I preach. I've always wanted to live in a clean, renewable energy home, one that used no gas, that was purely electric, and where the electricity was provided by clean, renewable energy, in this case, namely sunlight. And so that means everything is electric, my cars, my heating, cooling, stove. There's literally no gas on the property.
The bigger the problem, the bigger the opportunity. And this is one of the reasons why I chose civil engineering, and specifically in construction, just because there's these gigantic opportunities by being such a backward industry in general, especially in residential construction, that I thought this is where you can have the biggest impact. It's not an incremental improvement. There is really, you know, 50 years to catch up behind, you know, any, pretty much any other industry.